Welcome to the Four Listeners Program. Welcome aboard, everybody. Thanks for checking us out this week. On the mics this week is the Z-Man. What is up, Z?
Paranoia, paranoia, everybody's coming to get me. Just say that you've never met me. I'm running on the ground with the... I don't have no idea how that part goes.
Okay. Good job. Good job. No Ganthor again this week.
It's like he doesn't love us or anything.
I don't know. I'm seriously starting to question his dedication to this program, Z.
Yep.
Yeah, but filling in for the mighty Ganthor this week is a very good friend of mine, Stacie. What is up, Stacie?
Hello. I am very happy to be subbing in. If you need a replacement, just let me know.
Ooh.
Happy to join.
Ooh, look at that.
Ganthor better fucking show up next week. I mean.
Yeah, I'm throwing all the cards out on the table.
Look at that, Ganthor. You best get your shit together because Stacie came to play.
Yeah.
So what? This week, something must be done about flying cars, Stace.
Oh, my God. Yeah, something needs to be done. It needs to be stopped, prevented, should not come to fruition.
Why? I mean, wasn't this the promise of the Jetsons way back when?
Wait. This is Earth. Jetsons, completely different, you know, whole different stratosphere there.
The Jetsons isn't Earth-based?
I thought the Jetsons was Earth.
Yeah, no, it's like a dystopian future Earth.
No, they're galactically challenged.
Galactically challenged.
They're not held back by gravity. They don't have any of those issues going on there.
Okay, all right. So fine. That was some other place in some other universe. So I guess that wasn't the promise then. But haven't we been talking about flying cars forever now? That's always been the promise. The promise of technology was going to deliver the ability for us to take to the heavens in personal vehicles. Why is that a bad thing?
I'm terrified of birds flying over my head and shitting on me. I don't need somebody's car landing on me. Just personally. I just don't like the idea of things flying overhead that are within close range of, you know, my personal being.
Of your personal being.
Yeah, don't come near me. I don't like planes flying overhead. Heaven forbid a car starts to get into that airspace. No.
And a car driven by a teenager texting, or a flying car driven by a teenager who's texting.
That's the scary part about this, right? I mean, we can't drive cars
in two dimensions.
In two dimensions, I would be skeptical of trying to move into the third dimension. There, I mean, we can't go left and right. Why would we try to go up and down?
Yeah.
Well, you know, when you start to put into the physics and all of that, I attempted physics in college several times. It failed me terribly. So at this point, there is no grounds for me to even be able to attempt to negotiate the physics of flight. It just is not possible. I don't think that there are a number of individuals out there that are capable of achieving the same thing. It's just ridiculous in my mindset.
I mean, to get a pilot's license is a whole thing. Right? And this is where Ganthor would be arguing about, flying is so much simpler than driving.
No. You don't have to pay attention nearly as much because you're like the chances of you actually hitting something randomly in three-dimensional space is pretty low.
Now. But imagine if the whole sky is festooned with fucking flying cars.
Yeah.
Your odds are going to go up quite a bit that you might crash into something. And then how high do you go? Do you go all the way up to the 35,000 feet? With the rest of the commercial airlines or whatever else? Or are you going to be flying at a lower altitude? And if so, is everyone flying at that altitude?
Well, it's kind of terrifying to think about it only because of the fact that anybody that gets into a plane and wants to fly has to put in a flight plan and say, this is where I plan on going. This is what I want to do.
And this is
most
how
of the
I'm
people
going to
that get in a car and go somewhere have no idea where they're going or what they want to do. They're just going somewhere for the hell of it.
Yeah, and they're letting Google Maps figure out how to get them there. I mean,
exactly.
How the fuck does Google Maps work at that point?
GPS is like, you're in the air. I don't know where the hell.
Well, I don't know where you are. I mean, the complexity.
Well, think about it. You got the traffic controllers who are navigating space as well and making sure that people abide by the rules and fly in the right flight paths. Like, how are you going to do that if that scales up?
Yeah, I don't know. Like, do you have to get in line to say, okay, I'm going to take off now? Because it's not going to be the magical, you know, world of a hovercraft that all of a sudden, you know, I'm going back to the future and my wheels turn up and everything pushes me up into the air and I can shoot forward.
Wait. So you're telling me it's not going to be that scene where he goes, Rhodes?
No.
Where we're going, we don't need Rhodes. You mean it's not going to be that?
No.
You're breaking my heart.
Yeah. Well, come on.
That's what it's supposed to be.
It's illogical.
Illogical. Thank you, Spock.
You're welcome.
I don't know, Z. does this sound like this is something that would that humanity could actually figure out how to do?
No, I mean it's gonna if it's ever gonna happen, it's got to be entirely computer controlled. You're just basically in a shuttle that drives itself.
So they're doing this whole thing with self-driving cars, and I'm skeptical of that.
Yeah.
There's enough risk involved with me behind the wheel, but at least at that point, I have some measure of control over what's going on. Am I really going to trust a computer to get me from point A to point B safely?
I mean, if you think about it, planes do that now, right? Most of the time, the pilot gets in there, he gets the shit off the ground, he gets it to cruising altitude, he hits autopilot, and we go. That guy's right up there taking naps.
Yep.
Drinking.
Doing whatever the hell he feels like, right?
So banging a stewardess.
Sudoku.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's already a possibility. But the fact is that I don't trust that an individual who has no specific concern for understanding and respecting the guidelines of taking to flight to step in and say, yeah, I'm going to be responsible for this, even if I am on autopilot, that I'm paying attention to shit that's going on around me.
Yeah. And think about just what about weather, too? Like, people aren't going to want to like, oh, I got to get to my buddy's house. Like, I don't care. It's raining.
People are stupid enough driving when it rains.
Yeah.
I mean, the IQ points drop sharply when moisture falls from the sky. Imagine when you're actually in the sky.
It's not as bad up there. That's what I heard.
What do you mean it's not as bad?
If planes can fly over it, why can't I?
What are you, fucking Dorothy?
Of course.
I mean, the other thing is to think about is maintenance. Like, how long do you drive with your engine light on? Or how long does a typical person drive with their check engine light on? You know, you don't fucking service your flight flux capacitor. You know, shit's going to start falling out of the sky, right?
Yeah.
Well, you just see lots of people stranded on the side of the road trying to go through people's garbage to find the enough energy to get themselves back up to 88 miles an hour.
Yeah, drop that shit into Mr. Fusion.
Right, and then what happens if you forget to fill up the tank?
Oh, shit. I'm falling.
You're right. It's not like you stall on the side of the road.
Yeah,
right?
It's not like you're pulling over on the side of the road. You put your blinkers on. No, you're dead. And you just blew up someone's house on the way down.
Yeah. My mom and dad will pay for that. I'm covered.
Yeah, I'm insured. It's cool.
Yeah, affluenza? Come on.
And then you're sitting there going, oh, I should have put more than $5 worth in.
Yeah. Right? Wait until the whole argument of the fact that we are endangering all the fowl and birds of the air.
Oh, yeah. Wildlife.
All
yeah.
that shit. Oh, no. You know, the geese can't migrate because there's a bunch of cars flying around getting in their way, confusing them.
The swallows can't get back to Capistrano. What the fuck?
Damn it. Damn, you can't dodge a deer. You can't dodge a bird. You're going to be in trouble up there.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. Right? I mean, you hit a bird or a goose or something like that.
Dinner.
Jesus.
Yeah, roadkill's a little different when you chop it up with your prop.
Yeah.
Goose pate.
Like, oh, and again, now you got to worry about all that shit flying down on you, too.
Right,
raining down from above. Fucking chicken heads or duck heads falling on your lap while you're walking around.
Yeah. Well, is it raining? No, that's...
No. It's bad enough with the fucking blue ice, right?
Oh, God.
You know what? Maybe it'll facilitate it'll trigger another round of evolution where geese will start walking and they'll say, fuck the wings, I'm getting arms.
You're going to go around punching humans.
What the fuck are you thinking?
Hey, fucktard.
What the hell's the matter with you?
I was happy up there. You ruined it.
You ruined it. And then how do you do spinning rims?
Oh, dude, there's going to be some insane ground effects. There's going to be like UFO shit, like just like Close Encounters of the Third Kind stuff.
But sorry, that begs the question: what do these things look like? I mean, some of the flying cars that you're seeing today are—they're cars. They're cars that have wings that fold down, and then
no, I don't want that. I don't want no airplane like vehicles. I want shit that's got like I don't know anti-gravitational
Iron Man repulsor lifts. And...
Yeah.
You want a nice aerodynamic pod that doesn't look like a piece of shit.
You want a flying fucking saucer, is what you want.
Yeah. So they're trying to actually design these planes so that they can fly on standard gasoline. I don't trust anything that's going to put me up in the air using standard gasoline. I want something with rocket fuel if you're going to put me in something that flies.
What rocket fuel? Are you fucking crazy? I mean, think about it.
I want it to get me from point A to point B in sub-zero seconds.
Are you out of your fucking skull? I mean, think about it. I mean, that car that turns into an airplane has a little propeller on it. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that thing ain't gonna take you into the stratosphere.
There's nothing sexy about it. That's all I can say.
All right, but at least you're sexy. Sexy is what? Lighting yourself on fire? Is that what sexy is?
Definitely.
Right, that's so sexy.
So now when that plane falls out of the sky, it's got extremely combustible boom juice.
There you go.
Wait a minute. You're fucked up. Because you started this whole thing saying that you would be terrified of somebody falling out of the sky with one of these things. And now you're advocating for these things to be loaded with rocket fuel.
Well, I'm saying if we're going to go down the road and they're going to make it happen, then they better make it sexy.
Jesus.
Because that's the only way I'm going to buy into it. Otherwise.
You're out of your skull. I'm done with this one. We got to get another one, Z.
All right.
I'm done with this one. She's out of her mind.
Yeah. No, I just... It's just the overall paranoia when you start talking about the fact that the FAA has banned, you know, the drones from coming within, you know, human areas and spaces. I mean, they had to change all of the policies around all of that stuff before they can even negotiate allowing a car to be flying in the air.
Yeah. So
that's fine by me.
I'm terrified of the drone thing. Terrified. Why? Dude, I'm gonna be like that old crusty guy with a shotgun sitting on his porch just taking drones out of the sky.
I have one.
Don't fly it near my place because I'll take it out.
He's not allowed to.
No one wants to see you jerking off in your room, dude.
No, that's not the point, okay? Imagine now that you have all these drones flying around delivering Amazon boxes. You got people driving.
Dude, they are never going to have this Amazon shit. I don't know where that came from. There is no fucking way that they're going to do that.
They're
going to
do it.
Dude, because that's what's going to happen. People are going to be out there with their shotguns trying to pick up the bounty.
Well, the thing is they changed the rules as soon as Mexico tried to smuggle in drugs with using one of them.
Yeah, exactly. It'll never, ever happen.
It's going to happen.
It's not going to happen.
Here's what's going to happen. Have you seen this new thing that Amazon's got that they want to put a button?
Yes, I saw that today. It's ridiculous.
What do they call it?
I don't remember what it is, but it's essentially it's a product-specific button that you stick next to the product itself. So when it's empty, you push the button, and Amazon delivers it to you the next day.
Right.
So and my comment was, as soon as your kid finds this thing, it's going to be like, beep, 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 beep.
Exactly.
So, I mean, imagine you hit that button, and then all of a sudden, like an hour later, you hear the whirring of rotors as the fucking drones come into your place with your coffee and your laundry detergent.
What's the Flight of the Valkyries?
Dun, 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 dun. And here comes your fucking coffee.
No. We're just getting like one step closer to the world of WALL-E, where we're all a bunch of fat fucktards sitting on little chaise lounges floating around and out in outer space, drinking our dinners through a straw.
In a cup.
Sounds good to me.
Have a cupcake in a cup.
Have my meatloaf and mashed potatoes to go.
In a cup. It's
sounds
coming,
good to
man.
Me. Sign me up.
That's what this is. I'm terrified by all of this nonsense, man. I can't deal with people. I can't deal with the drones in the air. I can't deal with people in the air, and then I can't deal with people and drones in the air all at the same time.
No.
What else drives that kind of paranoia for you? Like, what do you almost immediately react to?
Nothing.
Paranoia of being asked a question about what your paranoia is.
Yeah, that's very good.
Now, I can say that there is one paranoia that does come to mind from a driving perspective. I actually have a paranoia of driving through intersections.
Well, that's probably good if you live in Jersey.
Can't get left.
Yeah,
just like keep going around the circle.
Yeah, I have a paranoia of like going through an intersection where the light has just turned green. I'm terrified of the fact that somebody's going to run that red light because I've actually watched it happen. So, I do have. A bit of hesitancy once I start to go through an intersection. I actually feel my heart rate go up.
No kidding.
All right. Note to self, don't drive a Stacie.
That's right.
Oh, I got one that freaks me out.
Oh, what's that?
It just happened to me yesterday. I was sitting in my apartment. I had the lights turned down low because I was playing Far Cry 4.
Oh, nice.
And
Kenny G.
And I had the the all my lights out, and it's just the glow of the TV on the hardwood floors.
Yeah.
And this fucking I think they're called water bugs. The thing that looks like a millipede with like crazy fucking legs all over the place.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Comes scurrying across the floor, and I almost yelped. I almost fucking screamed like a little girl. Things scared the shit out of me.
Was that just because it was dark?
I don't like bugs, as most people don't, but fucking bugs with many legs scares. Oh my god, gives me the heebie motherfucking jeebies.
Yeah, I'm with you on that one.
I think it was insane looking. I don't know where it came from. Even after I squished it, I still was scared to pick up the paper towel.
Yeah, that's right.
It's like I didn't know where he went. I squished him so hard, he turned into liquid. I had no fucking clue where this thing went. And I'm like poking it with a stick. I'm like,
you never got him.
I totally got him.
No.
Oh my god. And then the thought of that thing like crawling around my house while I was sleeping and possibly walking across my face or in my mouth or something. Oh, fucking crazy ass, creepy ass bug.
Tomorrow morning when you wake up, it's gonna be on your toothbrush.
Oh,
and it's gonna be like, oh, you killed my brother.
Oh, don't do that, because now I'm gonna be looking at my toothbrush.
Oh, my toothbrush is in a cabinet. Bugs can't get the cabinets, right?
No, definitely not.
They can't get in the cabinets.
No. The worst is when you think you got it and then it took off and then you can't get to it anymore.
Yeah.
Like if you're trying to chase down a spider.
Well, those things can jump. You ever see that guy trying to catch one of the spiders like with a Rubbermaid bowl and the thing like jumped on his face or something?
Ugh!
I hate spiders.
I don't want to talk about spiders.
Oh, spiders run. Like they got mad quicks. So you gotta fucking if you're gonna
They got mad quicks?
Mad quicks.
Where the fuck are you from?
Wait a minute, I need to Google that.
1992.
92? Mad quicks. Mad I'm Googling quicks. It right now.
Go ahead. Look it up. It means they got speed.
What? It's right after mad cow disease.
That's
so.
Right. That's right. They're fast, okay? God damn it.
Nope. I'm not getting a hit, so
well,
you fail.
Google's index isn't updated with facts from 1992 is clearly what's happening.
Oh, okay. Let me go update Wikipedia quick.
You need to go to the Internet Time Machine, into the Wayback Machine, and you need to go look up Mad Quicks is what you need to do.
I'd rather travel in a time machine than in a flying car. Let me put it to you that way.
Well, I mean, it wasn't Back to the Future was a flying car time machine. So what you need to do is go get yourself a DeLorean and then hook yourself up and off you go.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. That DeLorean had mad quicks.
Mad quicks.
To get to 88 miles an hour.
Dude, my Chevy Citation could get to 80 miles an hour.
I've seen a horse and buggy go faster.
But you slap a flux capacitor and a Mr. Fusion on that fucking Chevy Citation, and you got yourself a time machine. You go for it.
So if I could have an option to choose between what they should actually spend their money on, investing in figuring out flying cars, or investing in figuring out teletransportation, I would rather see them invest in teletransportation.
What, you mean like fucking beam me up, Scotty?
Yes.
Why? Everybody would agree with that. Yeah.
No, I wouldn't agree to that.
Why not?
Because you're going to fucking digitize my person and then reassemble me somewhere else.
I'm okay. Yeah, if you can make my ass smaller, I'm all for it.
If you could rearrange my molecules or leave a few out.
Yeah, you know, move a couple up to the boobs. I'm good. Yeah, you shift some of that shit around as I'm transporting. I'm all in.
Oh, forget about plastic surgery. That'll be the whole thing.
Yeah, Kim Kardashian would be like, thank you.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind taking some of the stuff in the middle and moving it a little further down. That's all.
What, to your toes?
Yeah, that's exactly right. I want bigger feet, Stacie.
There you go.
Yeah, that's exactly what I want. No, I wouldn't sign up for teleportation.
No, I'm all in on that.
Yeah, absolutely, dude. Then you don't even have to worry about commute. You can just live wherever the fuck you want, and you just can magically transport. Then you don't have to kill time just sitting in traffic and shit.
The idea that I'm going to be disassembled and then reassembled someplace else bothers me. I mean, because you're talking about it at the atomic level.
Yeah, but I'm okay with that. I don't need all of me. If I lose some in the transport, I'm good.
But what part of you would you be willing to lose?
I told you already.
Yeah, all right, so pretend it's not your butt.
Dude, it's like a VM, man. You can just, like, clone yourself, and, like, in case you get corrupt, You can restore? Yeah, you restore from a backup.
Great.
Yeah, you got a backup drive.
From a snapshot.
That's great. So my digital self is going to be up in the cloud. You want to talk about privacy problems? My whole fucking me would be in the cloud. Not information about me, not my email, not my fucking medical records. Me in the cloud. You want? Is that a good idea?
Yeah, that I'm okay with
great.
That.
Oh my god, you guys are fucking crazy.
Yeah, but by that point, it doesn't matter. No one's going to give a shit about you because there's going to be so many other people that they can see.
Right. Oh, that's great. So you picked me right up there, didn't you?
Yeah. They're not going to steal me. They're going to go get a guy like Steve Jobs if he wasn't dead, or you know, somebody like that. They're not going to steal me.
That's great. So that would be even better. So now you're gonna go grab a Steve Jobs or a Bill Gates or an Eric Schmidt or something along those lines, and then what? You're gonna turn them into an evil genius?
Yeah.
That's great. Let's go get the smartest people on the planet. We're gonna put their digital selves up in the cloud where they can be pulled down, reconstituted, and then made into evil geniuses. This is a terrible idea.
Sounds amazing.
It's a lot better than me worrying about some fucktard flying around crashing into my head because the idiot decided that they wanted to fly in a tornado.
I would be so much happier having a sliced up goose fall on my head because some fucktard flew through it. I would be perfectly happy with that, knowing that we don't have an army of stolen evil geniuses running around. Like, could you imagine someone cloning Stephen Hawking and then turning him into evil Stephen Hawking?
That would be awesome.
How would that be awesome?
I've seen that TV show already.
I mean, that's the whole world we live in, right? Parallel universes that are very close to each other. Things happening at the same time, but there is a good you and a good and a bad me and all this stuff happening simultaneously.
I'm stunned by your desire, by your willingness.
Dude, if technology has advanced that far by that point that they can actually do this, who cares?
Yeah, I'm
signing up. At that point, who cares?
What? Me?
The world is so – there's not going to be such thing as privacy. There's not going to be such thing as any of these concepts that we're talking about. It's going to be like Mad Max.
It's going to be Mad Max. That's exactly right. Because evil Stephen Hawking will have created an apocalypse.
Evil Stephen Hawking will probably figure out a cure for ALS and he won't have any problems.
Right. And that's when evil Stephen Hawking takes over the world. I mean,
that's,
you know, what the worst part about that is? He would still be talking through that creepy voice box because he'd be evil Stephen Hawking.
That would be brilliant. I would love to see that.
You're fucked up.
Of course. That's why you're my friend.
I don't even know what to say to you. What? All right, fine. What did we learn? Because I'm leaving it at that. What did we learn about flying cars, about things that we get paranoid about other whatever the fuck. What did we learn, Z-Man?
Evil Stephen Hawkins would be the greatest name for a band.
Holy shit.
That is awesome. I would love to hear that.
How about you, Stace? What did you learn?
I learned that I have an extremely long list of paranoias. I just don't want to expose them right now.
All right. There you go. What did I learn? I learned that you cannot Google the definition of Mad Quicks.
No, you cannot.
That's disappointing. So if you've ever used Mad Quicks in a sentence, or you enjoy the idea of flying cars or evil Stephen Hawking, why don't you go ahead and let us know on the Facebook page, facebook.com/4listeners or 4listeners.com. You can check out the show on Stitcher Radio or on iTunes. Just search for 4listeners and we'll pop right on up. Thank you, Stacie. You've been a marvelous guest. Thank you for sharing all of your paranoias with us.
Happy to join.
And we thank all of you for checking us out this week, and we hope that you will check us out again next week. Thanks a bunch, everybody.